Hey there. In this tutorial, we're going to identify items that need to be forecasted with a growth rate, right? Something like sales, for instance, grows each year, we hope. Your company may be declining, and if that's the case, you'll find a negative growth rate. Some other things that can be forecasted with their own growth rate are something like debt. You might look at your long-term debt and find that it doesn't follow any particular pattern, right? And you might want to use your own, you might want to calculate a growth rate for that. I've identified additional paid-in capital. It's growing, but it appears to be growing as a percentage of sales, and so I'm just going to give it its own growth rate. And also treasury stock, which is declining as a percentage of sales, but still growing in value. So I'm going to give those three items growth rates. Take a look at your income statement and balance sheet, and if you think something needs a growth rate, you know, plug it in as a growth rate. If I have a strong reason for disagreeing, I'll let you know and maybe you can change it. All right, so our growth rate formula, it's the geometric growth rate formula, the same one we used calculating dividend growth rate. And it's the newest value divided by the oldest value, and then raised to the 1 over n minus 1. So in this case, we've got 5 years of data, and so that's 4 years that it grew, 1, 2, 3, 4 growth periods, so it's 1 over 4 minus 1. And that is roughly 7.76% per year, right? That's going to be Hershey's growth rate. And it's yellow, or sales growth rate. I want to clarify that because it's different than free cash flow growth rate, which we'll get to later. I'm going to clarify by putting it in yellow that this is a growth rate. You want to do that because when you're forecasting and you're going item by item for the next part of the project, you want to make sure that you treat growth rates like growth rates and percentage of sales like percentage of sales and subtotals and totals like subtotals and totals. So I'll do the same thing down here for additional paid-in capital. New value divided by old value. Raised to the 1 over n minus 1. So additional paid-in capital is growing 13.39%, quite a bit different than our sales growth rate. If you do use a growth rate and it ends up being roughly the same as your sales growth rate, then you can just forecast it as a percentage of sales. And for treasury stock, new value divided by, new value divided by old value, raised to the 1 over n minus 1, minus 1. So treasury stock is growing more slowly than sales, and additional paid-in capital is growing more quickly than sales. Right. So that leaves us with not a lot of things left. We just need to forecast depreciation and amortization, and interest, and that's it. All right. Oh, and taxation and our tax rate. Before I move on, both of these things are growth rates. And happy calculating. I will see you in the next tutorial.